Hello, welcome back. Now, today I hope to finish the lizard completely. And what I've got to do is try and get the shape. At the moment, it's looking very flat, so I need to darken up the shadows and lighten up the highlights. And I'm going to first do that with the airbrush. So a little bit of water in there just to clean it up and make sure it's the airways are clear. Yep, that's fine. So the of course, the shadows on the yellow areas and the shadows on the blue areas and the highlights on the yellow areas and the highlights on the blue areas are different colours. So I'll have to do it in two goes. And I'll start with the shadow, the yellow shadow. Let's get some cadmium yellow. And then a yellowy brown, which Mars brown will do. And I want this quite dark, so I'll put a little bit of black in there as well. That's rather a lot. Lighten that a little bit. That should do it. Yeah, that's working okay. Nothing quite like the airbrush for putting nice shading on things. As has always been the case, this leg's tricky as it's got both colours mixed up in there. I think I want a little bit darker as well. See what that's like. Yep, that's okay. I think I'll put a darker blue in there now for the blue scales. So get rid of the yellow from the airbrush. We use this is quite a dark blue, and indigo is even darker. Touch of black. A bit too dark. Anywhere I've obliterated the actual scales with this process, I'm not too bothered because I will just put them back in later. In little spots of blue in here because he does have these little blue patches. Right, now the Do the same thing for the highlights. So I'm going to add some white gouache. Now this white gouache is a little bit tricky to airbrush, as white has a lot more pigment in it. Let's get rid of this dark. And with a lot more pigment, means it's clogs easier. Seems to be going okay. Oops, nice splatter. Never mind, we can fix that later. That's enough for the blue. Actually, that splatter, now it's dried, it's hardly noticeable. Right, same thing, this time with the yellow. That mix up a new yellow, it's a bit too dirty. I want to go a little bit lighter, a bit more white. Right, so that'll do with the airbrush for now. Now what I've got to do is sharpen up some of the details I've made a little fuzzy with the airbrush. So let's have a look. This head, started head, his eye needs cleaning up. So I'll start off with a largish brush. There's this little blue spot on his head. I must put that in because I believe that's his third eye. A little patch of light sensitive cells to tell him what when it's day or night. There's lots of little patches of blue and the yellow on the skin, not the scales. So I'm just going around these yellow ones in little places. Not being massively careful, just an impression of it. A little bit of a lightest brown. And his eyes. I don't think that's right. See how that dries. I need a darker brown for the, just to re-establish the mouth. Clean up that bit of overspill. Needs a little bit more light in that eye. Try and get a point on the brush. that very pale yellow. Crisp up this highlight here and a few other places. Looks very bright at the moment, but it'll, as usual, it'll tone down once it's dry. Just seems to have caught the light a bit down here. I think there's a few touches of pure white on the head, or near pure white. And I think some lighter blue bits here and there. Getting close to finishing now. This is a much, I've just watered it down, so this won't be anywhere near as bright when it dries. Slight tinge of blue around this crease in the mouth there, and a patch there. Very strange. Getting close. Just go back to the yellow. And whereas it's got, he's got little blue bits in the yellow, he's got little yellow bits in the blue. Right. Just about to say that's done, but there's a bit of dark patch around here. Want to darken it up a little bit more. Just that I just want a slightly lighter patch in the eye, just to bring it to life a bit. Right. I'm going to call that done. So, what colour shall I use? This blue. And the rule is, once you've signed it, you're not allowed to touch it anymore. So, I think I'll sign it down here. And that's it. Definitely now calling that done. Been a bit of marathon over 5 live streams. Not sure what I'll be doing next, but I'll think about it. Maybe something a bit quicker next time. Maybe something for Inktober, because the next one will be in October. Well, thank you for watching. Hope to see you on the next one. Bye.